What's going on, guys? Welcome back to the Watch With Us YouTube channel. Today we are doing a top five video. My name is Anthony. I also go by Watch With Me. You can find me on YouTube at Watch With Me or on Instagram as well, Watch With Me. Today the top five episode is going to be on YouTubers specializing in watch content, my personal five favorites, why you should check them out if you haven't already. Before we get into that, of course, a wristwatch check. Today I am wearing my Rolex Submariner. This is a transitional model. They only made it for 9 months. The reference number is a 168000. The first time they used the 904 grade steel, and as you can see, it has what we call a sponge dial. I love it. I wear it a lot. Enough of my watch. Let's get into some YouTube creators. All right, so this is in no particular order, but number one is Theo and Harris. So I first got turned on to this channel by watching a collaboration video with, I believe it was Christian from Theo and Harris, obviously, Federico from Federico Talks Watches, and of course, Tristano from the Urban Gentry. So they were all three of them were doing a video, and Christian was extremely charismatic, and really I kind of felt like of the three he didn't know as much about watches. This was way early in his YouTube career, but he had a very likable persona about him, so I decided to give his channel a watch, and I was amazed. And I've been watching his channel for many years now, and the first thing I can say about his channel, he is by far one of the most professionally shot YouTube channels out there that are specializing in watch content. He works with Anna, who is also part of Theo and Harris, but Christian really has a way of storytelling and editing that keeps you captivated. It's one of the things I like most about his channel. I find it very entertaining, and I like that his videos don't go on too long. He keeps them from 3 minutes really to about 10 minutes, and that's about it. That's pretty much my attention span for watching YouTube videos to begin with. So one of the things that I mentioned earlier is that how charismatic I find Christian, and love him or hate him, you cannot deny that this kid is an absolute natural in front of the camera. He is not uncomfortable, you know, not the stereotype watch guys, but they're not always the most outgoing people, and you put them in front of a camera and they tend to freeze up. Christian is not one of them, and I find it very enjoyable to watch his content. He's extremely funny. I follow him on his Instagram pages, and I find him hilarious. So love him or hate him, give him a watch. So Christian from Theo and Harris really started out as kind of a pre-owned online watch shop. He was specializing in kind of the sub $2,000, $3,000 range timepieces, and kind of as time progressed, would go up in value in watches. Now he's claiming he's doing over, you know, $1 and $2 million a year in sales, which if that is true, congratulations, that's sick, especially for your age. What you've done and what you've built is amazing. I believe what he's now gearing towards is more of a media platform, being a content creator, and I can see success in that for him. He's a great storyteller, and he's building a great YouTube community. He has almost 80,000 subscribers, so that's going to be my number one choice on my list so far. Theo and Harris, if you haven't checked it out already, I'm sure most of you have, go check it out, let me know what you think. All right, next on the list, let's face it, if you're a watch guy or even know a little bit about watches, you know this channel. It is Houdinki, formerly just a blog, Ben Clymer, who was in finance, started out on Tumblr, I believe, and he named it Houdinki, and would just write about watches from time to time. And fast forward 10 years, and now it's become probably the most influential watch community group that you can even think of. They do collaboration pieces, they do video creation, they still write articles. They're the mecca when it comes to content for watches. I will say they do irritate me from time to time because I find that they are elitists. And if you don't like what they like, then you're not in the cool kid club of the watch community. So that's one negative thing I have to say about Houdinki. But let's face it, when it comes to content creation, no one's doing it better than them. They have the production, they have the reach, they can sit down and speak with any CEO. They're doing collaboration pieces. They really have their hands all in the watch market. They really even dictate the secondary prices on a lot of pieces. My personal favorite of their YouTube channel is their Talking Watches series, which I would probably go ahead and say is everyone's favorite topic that they have. If you look at the Talking Watches series, my two favorites have to be with John Mayer, number one, and of course the more recent number two that just came out. I find that John Mayer's collection is really on track with what I like in watches. He has a very sophisticated taste with, you know, Patek Philippe's, and he also loves the gaudy things like me, a solid gold Daytona with rubies and diamonds known as the rainbow. So if you haven't already, go check those out. Number two on my list, Houdinki. Number three on my list would have to be the Urban Gentry. Now, I've actually worked with TGV in the past. We've done a collaboration video when I was boutique director of Bremont. I invited him in when he had under 80,000 subscribers, and I must say, just my personal opinion of him, he was very professional, very passionate about watches, and I really enjoyed working with him. So that's why I put him on the list today. Tristano has built an empire on YouTube when it comes to watch content. He has one of the largest pages out there. He has over 300,000 followers, and it really has to do with a couple key factors. He is a bit unique, I'll say, charismatic in his own right, but he really kind of specializes in that entry-level segment, which I don't think, especially before him, not many YouTubers were doing. And he does it extremely well, where he can show that he's passionate about a $100 watch or a $50 Timex, as well as being absolutely in love with a $10,000 Rolex or Breitling or whatever. So he's really tackling the entry level all the way up to mid to high end. He does that quite well, and he was one of the first to really do it. He has so much power that he's even spun off YouTube careers for Christian, from Theo and Harris, from Federico Talks Watches. So love him or hate him, you have to respect what he's done for the watch community on YouTube. One thing I will say is that I personally find his videos a bit long-winded, probably too long for me to sit through the whole thing. That being said, I will watch every one of his videos. I'll skip through here and there, but a must watch if you're looking for YouTube creators out there. He's might not be everyone's cup of tea, but you can't deny that he will put out some interesting videos from time to time, even if you aren't a fan of his. Number four on my list is going to be the Watchbox. Now, Watchbox was formerly Watch You Want, that was bought by Gomberg Jewelers, and they've created a very large YouTube presence now. They have over 80,000 subscribers, and they really invested millions of dollars into a studio. One of the things I absolutely love what they're doing is they're creating 4 to 5 episodes a week, and they're all live, which allows the YouTube subscriber to really interact, to ask questions, and feel like you're part of the channel. Not just leaving comments, but in a live chat box, they'll answer your questions. So I think they're really kind of in the retail space, creating something very new on YouTube, where they're a big presence. And I think Danny Gomberg, the owner of Gomberg Jewelers, is really a genius in this segment. I do think that he's overextending himself. They now have their own watch box in Hong Kong as well as Switzerland, which they might be doing well, but we're talking about YouTube. And I don't know about you, but if you've watched the channel, I find the episodes coming out of Hong Kong and I believe Geneva, might somewhere in Switzerland, they're a bit awkward. That has to do, I think, with the hosts. It's very hard to find someone like myself that's so charismatic and so good looking. Totally kidding. But it's very hard to find someone that's going to be natural in front of the camera. And I still think that they might have passionate people working for the company with watches, but it doesn't translate well in front of the camera. So I think Danny's really trying to build this empire on YouTube, but he's kind of overextending himself in certain areas. But their main channel that's shot out of Philadelphia, I love what they offer is different hosts every day. So you might not like Tim that shoots, you know, 1 or 2 days a week, but you might like someone else that shoots another episode, and they offer different topics every week. So it's almost become like a network. They offer different episodes, and they're really doing something different in terms of the watch community. So that's why I think The watch box is something you need to check out. You do need to take everything with a grain of salt because, let's face it, they are a multi-million dollar retail space, and everything they're showing, they are selling. So take that with a grain of salt. Nonetheless, they're doing great work. I've known people that went and checked out their studio. It's top notch. They have their own film crew, their own editing, their own studio. It's amazing, and I can only hope to one day replicate what they have already. Last but not least is a YouTube channel called Watch With Us. Why would I not put my own channel on the list? Kind of halfway kidding, but to be honest with you, I do think that because of you guys, we've grown so fast. We've only been doing this for a few months and we're almost at 1,500 subscribers. I really think that we're gonna become a much larger presence, and that's because we're just like you guys watching. We are watch enthusiasts that eat, sleep, and breathe timepieces. That's all we wanna do is talk about it. We have some really interesting episodes coming up that no one has done before that we're gonna be starting. So we're excited to share that with you all. And just as I stated earlier with some other brands, if you don't like me, you don't like my content, you might like John's, or you might like Giancarlo's or Spanish Rob's. We're offering so many different content creators onto this one network, really kind of talking about watches from A to Z, from $10 to $1 million, everything you could possibly think of. So that's why I'm putting us on the list for someone to check out. If you're already subscribed, send this to somebody else. Get them involved in what we're doing. We're going to be doing giveaways. We're going to be doing get-togethers, events. It's going to be awesome. And we're just so happy that you have joined us on this adventure. But that is really it, guys. This is a longer video than I anticipated shooting, but there are a lot of great YouTubers out there. Leave a comment down below. Who are some of your favorite content creators that I didn't put on the list? And just as I mentioned in a previous video, if you have any recommendations for top 5 videos that you would like me to talk about, leave a comment down below and let me know. That's really it, guys. Thank you for watching. If you're still here and you haven't already, hit that subscribe button. I would really appreciate it. So we're the whole Watch With Us YouTube community. And until next time, take it easy, guys.